Hello. In today's video, we shall learn in detail about fungus Pyronema confluens. By the end of this video, you'll have a clear understanding about genus Pyronema, its different modes of reproduction involving plasmogamy, dikaryon formation, crozier formation, karyogamy, meiosis, ascospore formation, and also its life cycle. Let us begin with the introduction to Pyronema. Pyronema belongs to class Ascomycetes. It is a saprobic discomycete, usually found growing on decaying leaves or on half-charred wood and burnt places. The vegetative body of the fungus Pyronema is a mycelium, which is well-developed, filamentous, superficial, and sparsely branched. The cells of the hyphae are short, multinucleate, and septate. Pyronema reproduce both asexually and sexually. Asexual reproduction may take place with the help of conidia. Pyronema is a homothallic fungus and sexual reproduction is of oogamous type. The most distinctive feature found in genus Pyronema is the formation of a saucer-shaped fleshy ascocarp known as apothecium. Now, let us learn about the asexual reproduction in genus Pyronema. Though rare, asexual reproduction may sometimes occur by the formation of oidia or conidia. These asexual spores are produced in chains on certain erect hyphae of the mycelium called conidiophores. On germination, each conidium is capable of giving rise to a new mycelium. Next, let us understand sexual reproduction in Pyronema. Pyronema is a homothallic fungus. The two kinds of sex organs are produced on the same thallus. The hyphae-bearing sex organs become forked at one or more points. They branch repeatedly in a dichotomous manner. The male sex organ antheridium and the female sex organ ascogonium develop terminally on separate sister branches of the dichotomy. The hyphae-bearing sex organs lie close to each other. Both antheridium and ascogonium are multinucleate. By the way, if you're getting some value out of this video, please like and share the video so that all of us can learn, unlearn, and relearn together. Also, please consider subscribing the channel and press the bell icon to get instant notification of all the upcoming videos. Now, let us continue with the sex organs of genus Pyronema. The terminal cell of the male branch becomes club-shaped and is known as the antheridium. It is multinucleate and is borne upon one or two stalk cells. The male nuclei divide repeatedly to form several nuclei. The antheridium lies in close proximity to the ascogonium. Ascogonium develops on one or two stalk cells of the dichotomy. The terminal cell of the female branch forms a balloon-shaped, swollen, unicellular, multinucleate ascogonium. From the distal end of the spherical ascogonium arises a curved, slender, tubular, unicellular, but multinucleate receptive structure called the trichogyne. A crosswall is present between the ascogonium and the trichogyne. Both the sex organs, as they mature, enlarge in size. Next is plasmogamy. Plasmogamy takes place by gametangel contact. The trichogyne grows towards the antheridium. It bends and comes in contact with its apex. The wall at the point of contact dissolves and a pore is formed. The nuclei of the trichogyne disintegrate. The antheridial nuclei get surrounded with some cytoplasm and migrate into the trichogyne. With the disintegration of the wall between the trichogyne and the ascogonium, the male nuclei makes its entry into the ascogonium. Plasmogamy takes place, but karyogamy is delayed. The male and the female nuclei in the ascogonium do not fuse immediately. They are arranged in pairs to form the dikaryons. Several post-plasmogamy changes occur. A number of ascogenous hyphae arise from the sides of the ascogonium. A pair of nuclei migrates into each ascogenous hyphae from the ascogonium. These hyphae develop crosswalls and become multicellular. Next, let us look into the formation of asci. The terminal cell of the ascogenous hyphae becomes crozier-like. Nucleus of a dikaryotic cell moves to other cells with the crozier method, which is known as the method of dikaryotization. The two nuclei migrate into the hook-like structure. Both undergo division to form four daughter nuclei. Cell wall formation takes place, giving rise to a terminal uninucleate hook cell, a subterminal binucleate arch cell, which functions as the ascus mother cell, and an uninucleate stalk cell. Synkaryon or fusion of nuclei occurs in the ascus mother cell, forming the ascus. The mature asci are club-shaped structures. Next is differentiation of ascospores. The nucleus undergoes three successive divisions to form eight haploid nuclei. These nuclei get surrounded by cytoplasm and develop into ascospores. Next, let us understand the formation of ascocarp. A network of intercrossing hyphae are formed by the vegetative hyphae. This region is known as the hypothecium. Lying intermingled with the asci are unicellular filamentous paraphyses which run parallel to each other. The paraphyses and the asci together form a structure known as the hymenium. Peridium or rim is absent in this region. The mature fructification is dish-shaped ascocarp called the apothecium. As the number of ascocarps are produced very close to one another, they get enclosed or enveloped in a common sheath to form a compound apothecium. Next is the dehiscence of asci. The mature club-shaped ascus contains 8 unicellular ascospores arranged in a uniseriate manner. Due to high pressure within the ascus, the ascospores are thrown out violently. Each liberated ascospore, under suitable conditions, germinates and forms a new haploid mycelium. Finally, let us understand the life cycle of genus Pyronema. In the graphic representation of the life cycle of Pyronema, we can see the sexual mode of reproduction, which involves cytoplasmic fusion and transfer of nuclei, plasmogamy, formation of dikaryotic ascogenous hyphae, followed by karyogamy and meiosis. The fruiting body apothecia with paraphysis and asci develop. The life cycle of Pyronema is short-lived. Haploid apothecia with 8 ascospores are formed. Under suitable condition, they germinate to form new haploid mycelium. So today, we have learned in detail about the mode of reproduction in genus Pyronema. I have some practice questions for you. Please share your answers in the comment section below. You can pause the video and write down the questions if you like. Thank you so much for your time and participation. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please consider subscribing the channel and press the bell icon to get instant notification of all the upcoming videos. Also, if you want to discuss any particular topic in biology, please mention that in the comments section below. I'll see you there. Goodbye. All the best.